trying to film, and people want to talk right as I'm doing this. Unbelievable. With now over a million views on my channel and only 3,000 subscribers, obviously I don't bug people to subscribe to my channel enough. So before we get started here, please subscribe. And then after a couple videos, if you're bored, you can unsubscribe. In today's video, we're going to talk about the Baja gear that I've been wearing for 2020, specifically on these last two videos. Now, it changes every year because sometimes stuff goes bad, stuff starts to tear, and then I get new jackets or whatnot. This is only going to be for the wardrobe that I wear for Baja Diaries, because I got a couple emails where guys were like, hey, what are you wearing down there? Should I overdo it? Should I wear big jackets? Should I wear no jackets? So I think it's just good. I'll kind of go over what I've been wearing on these last two videos. Okay, so first up is, not going to go into what the best gear is, because pretty much, you know, whatever fits you when you go to the dealer, or if you buy stuff online, whatever fits you and you feel good in, it's fine as far as riding gear. And when I say riding gear is usually just some riding pants. I like to get off-road pants where they have some pockets and maybe a couple vents. That's pretty much it with that. My jersey, I usually kind of don't wear these a lot because I'm usually liking t-shirts and jackets or light windbreakers. We'll go into that right now after this. But yeah, so this is just kind of my answer stuff. I've been wearing this the last couple months on my adventure rides. This is kind of like the really important thing that you're going to want to take with you, whether you're traveling in the winter months or the summer months, or the spring months, is a nice pair of under thermals. Okay. Not underwear, but like thermals. Cabela's sells, pretty good stuff. They have like three different tiers, like, you know, really cold stuff, medium and light. You can also check out Bass Pro Shops. I usually take these because this is like going to make your gear get a lot warmer if you need it. And then if you don't, your gear is just good for like average temperatures between like 60 and 70 degrees. However, every Baja trip, even in the winter or the summer, temperatures can dip into the 40s and 30s at nighttime, or when that sun goes down. So again, this is probably the most important thing that I always take. And they're really easy to wrap up and throw in your backpack or your gear bag. So you have your under thermals, and then you have your riding gear, and now let's talk jackets. I usually, you guys have seen this thing. This is an oldie but goodie. This is made by Troy Lee Designs, and this is, I've been wearing this for like 10 to 15 years on off-road stuff, and I still use it. It's got like an exhaust hole in the back from a crash where the pipe burned a hole in my back. I mean, this thing is like literally bulletproof still. I still wear it. And this is my outer shell jacket, okay? So it's waterproof, rainproof, and it packs away good too. That's a good thing. You want to look in a jacket, make sure it packs away. In case you want to take it off, you could put it in your luggage and not be dealing with it. Depending on the weather, before I go down there, I will take, this is a like a full-on rain jacket. It's not, you know, it's just waterproof really. I take this as a backup. And then I put this away, and I'll put this on if it starts raining or if there's a lot of mist and fog and I'm dealing with that. So that's the second jacket. Okay. By the way, in the summer, I won't take this. This is just like something that's in the arsenal. Okay. So let's talk about this jacket. This is like what you see, the Patagonia. What is that? This freaking Sub-Zero K type puffer jacket. This actually got promoted to the Baja collection wardrobe for 2020. Because I, you know, we all have jackets and stuff we wear for like on the town or like our regular lifestyles. But I try to take old stuff if it's not already purposely bought in for off-road. So I just retired a gray jacket. You saw it in the this past Baja Diaries video when we went to San Miguel. That jacket, the zipper finally ripped. So this one is now getting promoted into the Baja Diaries wardrobe. And this, you know what these jackets are. They have them in the stores. They're usually, you can get them $400 for one, or you can get them cheap for $60. This is a Rip Curl, and I bought this at a surf shop, and it's warm. It's great for just wearing around when you get to places, and I actually starting to kind of get worn already. So there you go on that. So those are my three jackets, okay? And again, if I want to make this one warmer, I have my thermals for underneath. So there you go. That's kind of with that. Now, shoes, okay? So I've talked about these before. These are rainbow sandals. These things are built like tanks. You can wear these in the ocean, cross riverbeds, push motorcycles up hills. I had these right here. My cousin Pavel, died of cancer, and he gave me these just before he died. Kind of weird. And he's like, they're uncomfortable. Yes, they're uncomfortable because it takes a while for you to break these in. But once you do, these things are amazing. I will leave a link to Rainbow Sandals in my description box. And these right here, I've been wearing these for like 8 years. So look at how thin they are. They'll fit right into your bag. They slide right in there. They don't take up a lot of room. But in the winter time, I like to take boat shoes or like Vans, something as thin as these. Because I've just been liking the way shoes feel after riding all day in Baja and just throwing on some shoes. So if you could fit shoes in, some thin ones, that's kind of what I like. But in the summer, I'll take these. Okay, and then as far as boots, these I've been wearing for a couple years now. This is the Alpine Stars Tech 7s. Really comfortable. I have some CDs that are really stiff, you know. So make sure when you do go get boots, try them on in the store and think of them as wearing them around, wearing them all day long, because that's pretty much what you're going to be doing in Baja when you do that stuff. When you're wearing those. So anyways, if there's anything I missed, hit me in the comment section below. I'll answer your questions. And again, thanks for watching the videos. And probably next year too, I'll do another update on what I'm wearing. There you go. Have you guys bought a t-shirt from the store yet? Get on it. Prizes given out monthly. The link is in the description box below, and then here's some other videos that I can take you and you can also check out. We'll see you guys next time.